Welcome to a ProSites video. Today we are going to be taking a look at the monthly SEO reports, how to understand them, and what we can learn from these reports. One of the first things you will notice on these reports is that it offers a comparison between your last month's website traffic and the traffic from 2 months ago. Moving to the first section of the report, we have the data that has been collected from Google Analytics, covering website visits, page views, and bounce rates. Visits represents the total number of times your website was visited during the corresponding month. In this report, the client's website was visited 322 times last month and 340 times 2 months ago. The next field, page views, represents the number of times a page on your website was clicked on and viewed by a site visitor. During the last month, the client's web pages were viewed 708 times and 650 times 2 months ago. The third field is the bounce rate. The bounce rate is a percentage that represents how often site visitors left the website without viewing more than one page on the website. This can often mean the visitor located the info they were looking for and left the website soon after, or were unable to locate the information they were looking for and did not explore the website further. The average bounce rate is between 40 and 70% for websites. If the bounce rate is higher than 60, it lets us know that the design and structure of the website may be leading visitors away, or if site visitors are not finding the information they are looking for, and we may need to examine the content further. Websites with a bounce rate lower than 40% show us visitors are finding the website information informative and useful, and they are clicking through to other pages on the website and viewing more than one page. Below these three initial metrics, you will see a line chart signifying the daily traffic levels for your website. The blue line represents traffic during last month, and the orange line represents 2 months ago. Following these site metrics, we get into information on your website traffic sources and where your website visits are coming from. Visitors from search engines such as Google, Yahoo, and Bing are referred to as organic traffic. Traffic that comes to your website directly is referred to as direct or none. This represents traffic where the visitor typed in the website address for your site and went directly to your website. Direct traffic is usually the result of past patients or clients who are returning to your website or from visitors who have seen the website before. Traffic that comes from other websites on the internet and not from the search engines is referred to as referral traffic. Referral traffic would entail visits to your website from other sites such as social media and business listings. There are other traffic sources, but these are often less frequent, such as paid traffic, which would encompass pay-per-click traffic that is sent to your website from an internet ad such as AdWords. Email traffic would also include visitors who are directed to your website from their email. On the next page of the report, we see a bar graph representing traffic sources in contrast to the comparison month. This provides us with a great visual to monitor the changing traffic patterns for your website. Ideally, though, we want to see organic traffic being the number one traffic source, although there may be periods where other sources take the lead and are the top traffic source. Next in the report is a little information on your mobile website traffic. With your website's analytics, we can identify when a visitor with a mobile device visits your website. This is one field we see increasing quickly as clients develop mobile-friendly websites and as mobile technology gains an increased share of online traffic. The next page in the monthly SEO report looks at the top pages of your website by page views. The pages in this table were the most viewed pages of your website during the track time periods and offer us with some valuable insights into visitor behavior. Typically, the most viewed page on a website is the welcome page, which is designated in this table by a forward slash or is labeled as home. Each month, we can examine the top visited pages in order to help us determine what visitors we're looking for, if there are any trends, and if there is a certain topic that is more popular than others. In this table, we see that the contact page has had more visits last month compared to 2 months ago. This means visitors are looking for the contact information for your office. On the next page, we have the top keyword positions for your website. This is the keyword ranking section of your report, where we track the rank and position of your business in the search results for the search engines of Google, Bing, and Yahoo. The keywords you see in this table are based off of the landing page topics that were selected when we first began your search engine optimization campaign. On the left-hand side of the table, you'll see the keywords that were selected for your campaign. It's important to keep in mind that these are not the only keywords your website is being optimized for. These are just the keywords we are tracking, and they can be changed at any point during the campaign. Moving across the table, you will see three columns of numbers. Numbers in each column represent the position of your business in the search results. If you see a 1 in a column, this means your website is ranking number 1. If you see a 5, it's in position 5, and if you see a 20, it's in position 20. Each page in the search results typically features 10 positions or ranks. So the first page consists of ranks 1 through 10, page 2 consists of 11 through 20, and page 3, 21 through 30, and so on. These keyword rankings are one of the key performance indicators for your website's SEO campaign, and we always aim to deliver the highest rankings possible. As you can see, the first keyword we have here, Los Angeles Dentist, ranks in the first position on Google, but is in position 5 on Bing and Yahoo. If we search for this keyword on Google, we will find it in position 1 on the first page of search results. In Bing and Yahoo, it'll be on the first page, but will be in position 5. Sometimes you may see a 50 plus on a column, which indicates your business is beyond page 5 in the search results. This can be for a number of reasons, ranging from the level of market competition or website optimization. With this information, your SEO support team will be working to improve your ranking in the search results and position your business in a visible and competitive position. This concludes how to read your monthly SEO reports. If you have any questions regarding your reports, you can contact your SEO support team. Thank you for watching our ProSites video, and we hope to see you again for our next video.